Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In this particular video, I want to talk about the behavior of the service. In the previous video, I had shown that the onStartCommand method returns a integer variable. So to understand this, let us try to see what happens to the app when a resource crunch situation arises. Assume that I have an app that is running. In this case, it is a my grocery list. Then I start another app, and as I keep on starting multiple apps, there may arise a situation wherein a resource crunch situation will happen. And Android may actually decide to kill my app that is not running in the foreground. In case I had a service that was running in my app which is running in the background, then Android will not try to kill that particular app because service always gets a higher priority. But that doesn't mean just because you keep a service, it will not get killed. If the resource crunch actually do happen and it is very severe, the Android operating system may actually decide to even kill the app that has a service. To understand the service behavior, let us understand what happens to a service when a resource crunch happens. In this particular graph, you can see that there will arise a situation where the Android operating system has to intervene and it needs to kill the service. And later point in time, as the resources become available, there will be a time where Android operating system will have enough resources to host the service that had been killed earlier. Now the question is, what should happen to the service that has been killed? That is determined by the value that you have returned in the onStart command. Whether you want to restart the service and whether the restarted service will have an intent value populated so that it can continue with its work. If you return the integer constant start sticky, the auto restart of the service is guaranteed. The service will always automatically get restarted when the resources will become available, but it will get a null intent. Then you have a start not sticky. In this case, the service will not be automatically restarted. That doesn't mean the service will not get started at all. If you trigger an intent to start that service which had been killed, it will once again get restarted. And then you have another constant variable which is called as start redeliver intent. What happens in start redeliver intent is the service will always get restarted and it will always get the intent which it had received an earlier case before getting killed. Let us now spend some time in understanding the scenarios in which you would use these constants. In case of start sticky, you use this in case of services which are being explicitly managed. That is, it is a long running service, you are starting a service and you are stopping a service explicitly using start service and stop service methods, which I have explained in the previous video. The advantage of this particular start sticky constant is if the service gets killed, it will automatically get restarted. But when it gets restarted, it will not get the intent values. So the intent value will be null. It doesn't remember what was the previous calculated value in the intent. The typical scenario is music service, a music service which is constantly running a music audio. When it gets killed, it will restart when the resources are available, but with the null intent, so that it need not have to remember which song was playing earlier. You don't want your music service to automatically start blasting music in your ears in your unexpected time because it got killed some quiet time back. In case of start not sticky, you are not restarting the service, but if the intent is triggered, you will start it. The scenario is services are being run periodically and they self-stop. If service gets killed before self-stopping, it will not be restarted automatically. But after it getting killed, intent gets triggered, then it will be started. The best example would be an alarm service or a kind of service which runs periodically every few minutes or every few seconds to do some kind of a back-end job like polling the data from the server every 10 minutes or 20 minutes. So during that time, if if it gets killed, there is no need to restart it because it is always going to be once again triggered after 10 or 20 minutes. So tasks which need to be run in the background periodically are best examples of start not sticky services. Then comes the start redeliver intent. In this case, what is happening is the service is always going to get restarted and it will get the previous intent. The typical scenario when you would use start redeliver intent is a service is being explicitly managed and it's a long running service. If it gets killed, you want it to always get restarted and continue from where it had stopped. A typical example is file download. If file download service gets killed somewhere in between because of the resource crunch, and when later resources become available, the file download should continue from where it had been stopped. You don't want it to once again explicitly be started, which is a case of start sticky, or not started at all, which is a case with start not sticky. So start redeliver intent will make sure that it will remember the intent with which it had been triggered and it will continue from where it had stopped. So that is start redeliver intent. I hope this clarifies when to use start sticky, start not sticky, and start redeliver intent constants in the onStart command method of the service. Stay tuned, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Bye.